Hey y'all, welcome back. It's Bunny. Welcome to my channel, Color and Root. And we are going to try the finish of the Rocking Horse page in Joanna's Christmas. Alright, so let's get right to it. Ow. Oh yeah, I've been in a hang now and I just stabbed myself with one of these pencils. Okay, so we are going to finish up these leaves. Let's get to that. So I'm using, this here is pine green. Granny Smith apple is the light green. And then this is just regular green. And the berries, we are going to use red and, ruby red. So what is going on with everyone? Day's been good. Summer's going well. Down here, the kids will be going back to school fairly soon. It's sooner than they did last year, I believe. Some of the schools are going back starting August 2nd, which is super early. I feel for these kids. They hardly get any rest. And I know they say, oh well, they forget. The longer they're out of school, the more they forget, and things like that. But with the amount of homework they give kids nowadays, they need that break. I mean, I really think that's why the dropout rate is so high. It's like the kids are stressed out. Kindergartners are getting homework and projects to do. I mean, that's just... it's too much. Like, it's not the amount of time that you spend in school, it's the quality of the education. You have teachers who are overworked, they have too many kids in their classes, and they can only really focus on those standardized tests since they make those are so important. So it just needs an overhaul of the school system, really. And they'll start seeing better results. But stressing these kids out is not going to help the situation. It just makes more and more kids realize they don't want to be in school. It's crazy. And then on top of that, then they say, oh, we have to be well-rounded. So do an after-school activity. And it's like, whenever you're going to have time to do the after-school activity. Homework takes about 2 to 3 hours. Some subjects, the older you get, you can spend an hour on just that one subject. So now you're up all night. And if you do a sport, then you definitely up all night because you got hours of homework that you have to do once you come home from practice. So it's not feasible. It's too much. It's probably going to be a quiet coloring chat because I didn't think out a topic to talk about. This probably could have been a video with music on it in the background and just color, but I really don't feel like I can't even see. I don't feel like uploading this video to my computer. I just want to record and upload. That's how I'm feeling today. No, I just want to color. And it shouldn't take that long to finish. I mean, we only really have to finish up the horse, do the stars and some leaves. So it'll probably take the whole hour, but hopefully it doesn't take any longer than that. So I'm going in with the pine green and just catch the outside edges of the leaf. I was planning on doing some of these leaves off camera because I know my hand gets in the way on certain sides, but I went and worked on something else, and so, you know, that just didn't happen. And then the part that we're gonna use green to get the rest of the white part on the leaf. This is gonna be gold. And the stars are gonna be gold. The saddle and the squirrelies will be different shades of gold. And we shall be done. Oh, and we need to do the little birdies. I forgot about them. But they're gonna be red too. We kept our palette very limited. It's just a varying shades of green, red, and blue, and gold. So four major colors, really. So now we're gonna take our green and just fill in those white spaces. And what I liked about harder pencils that I probably wouldn't have been able to do once I get the softer core pencils is I can go over. I know, like right now, I'm not worried at all about going over in the blue, because unless I press really hard, this green is not going to transfer into that blue. That is one of the advantages of using hard lead pencils, is what is already covered is not as, it's harder to cover up again unless you use heavy pressure. But if you just go over it lightly, the color will not transfer to another color. And that's why I love these small elements for last, because if I had did them first, this I would have been careful not to get the green onto the background, because you would have seen the difference. Okay, so now I'm just gonna go over the whole entire leaf with the apple green, just to make sure everything is covered in. And I'm trying to move in a direction so that way I don't forget a leaf, because I have a tendency to go back in the picture and say, oh, I forgot that one. But I've noticed that if I move in a certain direction and keep that direction, then I'm more likely to get not miss out or leave anything blank. Okay. So that is our leaves. They are done and finished. Got it. Got it. Got it. Raspberry, I don't want that. I want red and ruby red. So I'm gonna go in with the red. Don't have to do them dark. All right, and then we're going to go in with the ruby red, and we're going to do circles this time and leave a light center. We're gonna do our bird. Let's do our bird red. Our two little birdies. All over red, like we did the berries. And then tail, I'm going to go over with ruby red. And I'm going to bring down like that. And then with light pressure, go over the rest of the body. And then let's add a pink. And it won't really look pink because we have the so much red going on. But it'll give it a nice different color. Yeah. So I just saw the trailer for the new Fantastic Beasts movie that deals with Grindelwald, and it looks pretty doggone good, I have to admit. And I may have to go see it. Alright, so that is our leaves and our birds. They're done. So now we're going to, let's keep our reds out. We're going to, let's get that on our stars here. So all over. Yellow, and this is golden yellow. So I am excited about a new movie. I mean, she has so much stuff in those books that if she wanted to spin off the books to keep making movies, she could. Like, I would love to see a movie chronicling the beginning of the Hogwarts, because really that's how Voldemort got his idea about wizards and only. So it would be interesting to see the formation of Hogwarts and then the fight that led to Slytherin leaving and doing his own deal and things. That would have been pretty good. So now I got Harvest Gold and I'm going to darken some areas up. And I don't have a rivalry, so I just like doing look random. I mean, that would be nice to have. And then maybe a movie about when Harry's parents were still, when they had the first deal with Voldemort. Right, that would be a nice one. So much With those movies. This one, I'm just gonna go over the top. And maybe. Same thing. Do with this one. I was sitting here thinking about Harry Potter, and I just thought of something super cool for my reading challenge. I just have to look it up and see if it's possible. Let's see how that works. You color and things come to you. Oh, I don't want dark chocolate. Brown. Okay, so now I'm going to go in with brown, and I'm going to have a fairly light hand with this brown in most areas, though I do want it dark in the creases. And then just slightly bring it up. This is my go-to way of making gold. Even though it's more like brass, because really gold doesn't tarnish. The more pure the gold is, it doesn't tarnish, so. This is either, you know, brass or a lesser gold with other things mixed into it. Let's say that. Definitely not 24 carats. It's the kind of gold I like to look at when I'm doing gold pieces. Oh. just gonna go right on that line right there. I'm not gonna add anything to that. I'm gonna do the same thing here. Just don't forget this harvest gold and go over that and blend it out a little bit. We have a festival going on this week, so maybe, you know, me and my husband get out and